Dear students, in last class we studied high AC voltage generation using cascaded transformers. Today we will study high AC voltage generation using series resonant circuit. Before we go to series resonant circuit used for high AC voltage generation, we will study what is resonance in series RLC circuit. Now let us consider RLC series circuit shown here, which is supplied with voltage V equal to Vm sin omega t. I is instantaneous current flowing through the RLC series circuit. Capital I is RMS value of the current. VR is voltage drop in resistance R, which is given by I into R. VL is voltage drop in inductor L, which is given by I into XL. VC is voltage drop in capacitor C, which is given by I into XC. For this circuit, impedance Z is given by under root R square plus XL minus XC whole square, where XL and XC are inductive and capacitive reactants of this RLC series circuit. Current I is equal to V by Z. When XL becomes equal to XC, XL may be made equal to XC by varying L or C or frequency of supply voltage. Then Z will be equal to R, because XL minus XC will become equal to 0 when XL is equal to XC. When Z is equal to R, the current flowing through RLC series circuit will be limited by only the resistance of the circuit. That is I equal to V by R, or V is equal to I into R. That is, voltage supplied to the circuit will appear only across the resistance of the circuit. Now this condition of RLC series circuit is called series resonance. That is, when XL is equal to XC, we say that RLC series circuit is under resonance. For a series resonant circuit, we define a term called as quality factor. Quality factor Q is equal to I into XL upon IR. That is, it is the ratio of voltage across inductance to voltage across resistance. That is equal to I into omega L upon I into R, which can be written as VL by VR, where VL is equal to the voltage across inductance and VR is voltage across resistance. Since VR is equal to supply voltage V under resonance, we can write quality factor as VL upon supply voltage. And here in this ratio, if I cancel I can also write quality factor as omega L by R. Quality factor gives us voltage magnification. By increasing L value, we can increase voltage across inductor. Since XL is equal to XC under resonant condition, by multiplying on both sides by I, we get I into XL equal to I into XC. I into XL is voltage across inductance and I into XC is voltage across capacitor. Therefore, VL becomes equal to VC, which means that increase in voltage across inductor results in increase in voltage across capacitor also. Now we will see how the resonance in series RLC circuit principle is used to generate high AC voltage using single stage test transformer to test capacitive load. Here is the single stage test transformer with capacitive load circuit. The first transformer is called the voltage regulating transformer. This type of transformer you must have seen in your laboratory, and you have called such transformers as auto transformers. And here is a step up transformer. Here you can see capacitance of the load, which is variable. Constant frequency, constant voltage source is connected here. According to the requirement, voltage is applied to the primary winding of step up transformer using voltage regulation transformer. Then the capacitance of capacitor is adjusted so that the series resonance occurs in RLC series circuit, where R is winding resistance and L is leakage inductance of the winding. At resonance, AC high voltage appears across the capacitive load. We can draw the equivalent circuit of this single stage test transformer with capacitive load. Here what you see is equivalent circuit of a single stage loaded transformer. Here L1 is leakage inductance of regulating transformer and the primary of step up transformer. L is magnetizing branch inductance. L2 is leakage inductance of secondary winding of step up transformer. And C is the capacitance of the load. The magnetizing branch inductance L is very, very large. So its shunting effect is very, very negligible. Hence, the value of L may be neglected, so that we can consider the entire equivalent circuit as series circuit of L1, L2 and C. So just write these details of circuit. usually the load capacitance is variable. For given frequency, at certain loading, resonance in the circuit may occur. Suddenly, under this condition, current through the load is limited by resistance of the circuit. And voltage across load capacitor may go up to twenty to forty times the supply voltage. The third order harmonics may appear when the core of the transformer gets saturated. These third order harmonics are found to be quite disastrous. Therefore, such a resonance is called unwanted resonance. At resonance omega into bracket L1 plus L2 is equal to 1 by omega C, and voltage across capacitive load VC is equal to magnitude of current at resonance and the capacitive reactance product, that is minus JV into XC divided by R plus J into the bracket XL minus XC, where R is the resistance of winding of the transformer. At resonance, we get it as v into xc divided by r, because at resonance xl will be equal to xc, so this imaginary part becomes equal to 0. Or we can write this as v into v by omega c into r. The development of series resonance circuit for testing purpose has been very widely welcomed by the cable industry, as they faced a resonance problem with the test transformer while testing short lengths of cables. There are two circuits in use for generation of high AC voltage for testing purpose using series resonance. They are single transformer or reactor series resonance circuit and series resonance using variable HT reactor. Here in the single transformer or reactor series resonance circuit, you can see regulator transformer, feed transformer, step-up transformer, which is called main transformer here. In the primary of this step-up transformer, a variable reactor is connected. And in the secondary of the main transformer and feed transformer, capacitive load is connected. In this circuit, we can think of transferring variable reactor to the secondary of main transformer or step-up transformer. When the reactor in the primary of main transformer is transferred to the secondary side, then its value will become n square into L, where its value is L on primary side. For step-up transformer, we know that transformation ratio N is more than 1. Therefore, N square into L will be more than L. For higher transformation ratio, N square becomes still higher and N square into L will become much more than L, that is inductance on primary side. So, while testing short length cables, even if the capacitance value is very low, due to which the capacitive reactance value becomes very high, by using this circuit on the secondary side of main transformer or in series with capacitive load, the inductance value may be increased and the resonance may be attained very easily. So now we can write here, at resonance, N square into L into omega will be equal to 1 by omega C2. Here we have neglected leakage inductance of the transformers, because N square into L in comparison with the leakage inductance of transformers is very, very high. In this method, both the secondaries of transformers have to carry full load current under resonance condition. This is a disadvantage of single transformer or reactor series resonance circuit. So we'll just make a note of it. The inductor is designed for high value of quality factor. Q. That is Q equal to omega L by R. In other words, R the resistance of transformers are kept very low. Hence, feed transformer has to supply losses in the circuit only. These days, it is possible to manufacture the reactors which can be varied over a wide range, having high voltage rating, that is up to 300 kilovolt per unit, using a new technique with split iron core. With this method, the testing step-up transformer can be avoided, which we studied in last method. Here you can see a series resonance circuit with high voltage reactors which are varied by using a motor. So here step up transformer is missing, only the feed transformer is available. By varying the inductance and making inductive reactance equal to capacitive reactance, we can have a resonance in the secondary circuit of feed transformer. The equivalent circuit for series resonance circuit with variable HT reactor, HT means high tension, which we have used here, is shown just beside the first figure. So I have written here equivalent circuit. So what all you can see? A effective inductance L, that is here, and a voltage source. That means this feed transformer and a source behind it all together have been replaced by this voltage source. And here you can see the capacitive load C2. Under resonant condition, the output voltage will be V0 equal to V by R, that means current, into 1 by omega C2, that is capacitive reactance. So by this we can understand output voltage is measured across the capacitive load, where V is supply voltage. Since at resonance omega L is equal to 1 by omega C2, V0 may be written as V by R into omega L. Here I am replacing 1 by omega C2 by omega L, because omega L and 1 by omega C2 are equal. And we know that omega L by R is Q, so I can write V into Q. Where Q is quality factor. Q value varies between 40 to 80. It means that for Q equal to 40, the output voltage V0 is equal to 40 times the supply voltage. Also, it means that the feed transformer has to supply kilowatt equal to 1/40th of kVA of load capacitor. This results in small power rating of the feed transformer. Dear students, in the next class, I will take the advantages of the series resonance circuit used for high AC voltage generation, and also I will solve one numerical based on resonance circuit. I will stop the class now. Thank you.